Hey everybody, Jazzy here with another Don't Starve Hamlet Guide. And hey Wes, you look like you're adjusting to your new surroundings rather nicely. I'd say your first 11 days were spent well, which is mostly self-praise because you were following my orders like an obedient slave, with a trip to the Rock Island and the Palace Hamlet. You've got most of what you need to start preparing for the upcoming dangers. Now, let's make sure you are prepared for the humidity and the rain. That's right, my scrawny little mute adventurer, I'm talking about humid season. Humid season, like all Hamlet seasons, spans 11 days, the first one starting on day 12 and ending at the top of day 23. There are a number of seasonal dangers involved here. First, rainfall and lightning will start to occur much more frequently, similar to spring and hurricane season in other DLCs. In addition, you will experience periods of heavy fog which will raise your wetness unavoidably and slow your movement down to a crawl without proper gear. Also, those cute little glowflies you saw flying around during temperate season? Yeah, they're about to emerge from their cocoons as rabid beetles, a hostile mob that will attack you on sight and give chase very quickly. During this season, I like to stick close to home because travel through deep forest becomes extremely precarious. It's a good time to start setting up some pig shops and become self-sufficient. By the end of humid season, I really strive to get my sprinkler built and nettles planted and harvested once or twice. Now, because nettles are so location-specific, now would be a good time to briefly discuss base location. Generally, I see a lot of players setting up camp around the slanty shanty in the hamlet. This is certainly a safer approach to the early game because you are constantly surrounded by pig guards who will provide natural defense against bat waves. You are also far away from most hostile mobs in the wild. However, for the more experienced player, this location can become a crutch. You are further away from several important locations, including viable nettle planting areas and every ruins connecting to other islands. Don't get me wrong, you can totally get through lush season without growing nettles, but it will be harder on your sanity and slow you down considerably during a time that could potentially be very peaceful, almost comparable to temperate season. That is why for early game at least, I prefer more of a central location on my spawn island. It will put me much closer to these important areas, and I will waste much less time traveling through the cultivated biome just to get back to the wilderness. So Wes, let's start with the basics. Wear your pith hat during the fog. You got lucky and found one in the hat shop on the Palace Island, so that's taken care of. Had you not been able to buy one, you could have crafted one with vines, cork, and the cloth you hammered from your parachute. This is why I generally wait on using the cloth for a gas mask until I have fog protection. Another option is the bat cowl, but it requires a batalisk wing which we did not find in the ruins. So, pith hat it is. Now, about the rain. Wetness is not a massive danger besides the sanity loss from being completely drenched. But the easiest way to get 100% rain protection is a combination of an umbrella and hat such as a pith hat or football helmet. Fortunately, we grabbed the silk we need for an umbrella, so let's craft that now. Don't bother holding it during the fog, but do try to keep it equipped once the fog lifts and the rain starts to fall in earnest. Let's also put those reeds to good use by crafting a bird cage. Once you get a bird in there, you will want to build up an egg supply. Try to get at least 10 eggs to rot so that you can craft some gunpowder, which you will be using to find the Apocalypse calendar later. Around this time, you should get another bat wave, and if they come in the fog, you can find yourself in a potentially very dangerous situation. Wear the pith hat and log suit while fighting them to stay mobile and protected. You can bring them to pig guards, but if it's dusk or night, just know that their torches can burn the pigskin drops. I would also highly recommend burning down any clumps of wild grass growing near your camp. At dusk and night, weevils will spawn from them, and you don't want to be constantly badgered by them on top of everything else trying to kill you. Don't worry about wasting resources, there's plenty of tall grass in the wild. Safety takes priority right now. Also, looks like you made the questionable decision to camp very close to an Iron Hulk. I would recommend activating it with a pickaxe and luring it away from your base. They are basically living lightning rods and will activate if struck. You do not want one of these stomping through your base, so just get them away for now and let them run down. At this point, the eggs you've collected in temperate season should have gone rotten. Use them to prototype some gunpowder and store them somewhere safe. Okay, let's go plant the berry bushes that you borrowed from your pig guard neighbors. Berry bushes are awesome to have in Hamlet. They will never wither or freeze and will grow berries and spawn gobblers year-round, and they are a great source of oinks when traded to usher pigs. Keep checking on your nettles. They probably will not have bloomed from a single phase of humidity, but the good news is that even if they dry back up, they will pause their growth cycle. So eventually, with enough fog and rain, they should bloom on their own. It might just take a while. Okay, this right here is why you want to avoid deep forest during the season. Between the rabid beetles, spider monkeys, and snaptooths, you have a lot of hostile mobs to contend with. Fortunately, they enjoy nothing more than murdering each other, so just hang back and let them sort out their differences together. Then, swoop in and grab their loot when all is peaceful. Your stalking stick is probably getting a little low at this point. Good time to go hunt another flytrap for a stalk. Because of the difficulty in getting silk and hound's teeth early game, I don't generally use a sewing kit to repair stalking sticks. Just use them up and make a new one. Hey, guess what? Time to put that key to the city to good use. Let's build some pig shops. A good first shop to set up is an oddities emporium. It will require 3 ball peen hammers, which you should have the iron to make. This store is amazing. You can buy gears, hound's teeth, mandrakes, Reign of Giants boss loot, and trade with the collector pig. This guy is one of the most important pigs to trade with. He accepts a wide variety of mob drops in exchange for oinks, including crap like chitin and stingers that you really don't use all that much. And he has no cooldown on trading, which means you can trade with him as much as you want. If you find a gear in here, grab it and use it to craft an icebox for keeping your food preserved. Okay, time to start working on a smelter. You're gonna need a lot of cut stone for this, and if you don't feel like using up your rocks, there's a great source of cut stone nearby. Craft a pitchfork and go dig up that ancient pig ruins turf in Deep Forest. These will net you a cut stone for each tile you dig, and there is a lot of this turf to be found in the forest. So now let's grab a red gem, make a few boards, and craft this dang smelter. You will now need 2 alloy for your sprinkler, so let's get to smelting your iron. And yeah, time for another bat wave. The number of bats are going to start ramping up fast, and pig guards are going to be more and more advantageous for helping out with the waves. Until we get more watchtowers set up closer to our base, try to bring them over to the cultivated biome every chance you get. Yay, nettles! Deep Forest Ambrosia! It's close to the end of human season, so you might not get another harvest before the raiding stops. Good thing we're working on a sprinkler. We will definitely want to keep producing nettles well into the next season. Now that you have your alloy ready, the last hurdle to building your sprinkler is ice. Because of your unfortunate previous altercation with the local grocer, you won't be able to buy ice from her anymore. So we need to get a little creative here and rush our own grocer. We need 3 eggplants. Usually you can grab one from an improved farm in the cultivated biome. You can also get 2 by using the executive hammer to destroy the grocer in the hamlet. You know, the one from which mimes have been unfortunately banned. Okay, let's do this! 3 eggplants, 4 pigskins, and 4 boards. Voila! Your personal produce markets. Go buy some ice and let's prototype this sprinkler. Alright, now we just need to find a suitable location. You're looking for a spot in Deep Forest that's close to a pond, preferably with an area relatively clear of jungle ferns. Fortunately, we have such a spot close to our camp. We just need to clear a bit of snaptooth infestation first. Oh geez, you got poisoned again? I told you not to pet the scorpions, bro. I thought that went without saying. Well, at least we're close to the mud spa in the hamlet. Go buy some anti-venom and maybe a bit of extra healing. Oh, awesome. Insanity. Probably for the best. The next bit of crafting will call for nightmare fuel. Alright, let's head back, grab the final nettle harvest of the season, and start farming this nightmare fuel. The next shop you will want to build is an arcane shop. The lovely lady in here will sell living logs and other magic tab items. Plus, you can trade her nightmare fuel for money. Alright, let's chop a few more spider trees for silk and craft a bird trap. Hopefully we can score some birds soon and get to converting all this leafy meat into eggs. Hey Wes, time to hang up that pith hat and that umbrella. You've escaped the wetness and humidity for now, and you have enough nettles to get you through the next few days without brutally sneezing yourself into a coma. In the next episode, we will dive into lush season, what to expect, what to prioritize, and how to prepare for your journey to the Herald Island in order to stop the apocalypse. That's it for now, I hope you're finding these guides useful. And also apologies for the delay in releasing this recent installment. I did not anticipate how popular these guides were going to be, but since the game came out in full release, I have been made aware of the demand for a completion of this series, and I am more than happy to oblige. So stick around, subscribe to the channel, and I promise you the next installment will come soon. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.